never stop screaming. Okay, so here's his what he said. Okay, listen to this, babe.
Hey guys,
and you know he doesn't look anything like him.
I just wanted to tap in really quick. I just got this feeling, man, that this summer is it's about to be a white boy summer. You know, take it how you want. I'm not talking about like Trump, you know, NASCAR type white. I'm talking about, you know, me, John B, Jack Harlow type white boy summer. You know what I mean? Let me know if you guys can vibe with that and get ready, you know, because I am.
God, he sounds like a teenage girl.
It turns out.
But.
Well, first of all, there's nothing wrong with teenage girls.
And you're doing
an injustice to teenage girls by saying that about him. It turns out social media users could not, in fact, vibe with that. They could and did, however, produce an endless stream of white boy summer memes making fun of Chet Hanks' latest antics, to which he later responded in a follow-up video laying out the rules and regs of his so-called white boy summer.
Oh, God, he had to go further with it. He can just shut up and say, I tripped up. Sorry, fucking forget it.
Here's it. There'll be more rules coming.
I think he's actually trying to be funny.
Oh, you think so?
I think so.
I mean, I hope that's true.
I think it is. But it's still just as bad. When you're that bad at delivery and judge of what's funny, it's just as bad. It really is.
I was gonna go on this whole undertale.
You're social dysfunctional. If you can't figure out humor, then you ain't right.
Well, he said some other things that make me think that he really wants to capture the swag of blackness and be in that vein.
Yes, I think
he wants that to be his lane, but he just.
Yeah, this is his way of making fun of white boys. Like none of that kind of white boy stuff. No, none of that. Right. I'm a down white boy. I'm not like that.
Right.
But how old is he?
30.
Oh, fuck me. Yeah, you know, exactly like a 16-year-old. I just heard rap for the first time. You know, it's just...
Half a little Wayne song?
That's all me. I set you up for that. All me. All me on that one. I get more than assist on that. Oh, my God. Yes, indeed.
But I do have a question, though. Like, he should know better. Okay. But
he should. That's why I say it right. At some point, your judgment clicks in and says, oh, fuck, you know. You got to get behind what the rest of the world's thinking.
But there is this stereotype or zeitgeist or whatever you want to call it of black male masculinity that's supposed to be hypersexual, and it's been used against black men, right? Like
right.
For Lynch, but and it's still used against black men, but there's this other side of it where capitalism puts rappers forward who say that's all they're about. I get all the bitches and you know all the you know blah blah blah. So if that's the zeitgeist, it doesn't really surprise me.
The black brads are like, Jesus, now the black guys got the white guys thinking like them. Fuck us.
I was just going to say, if that's the undertone, how surprised can anybody be that somebody who's not black would try to adopt that? If you're 30 and you want to be cool and you want to get all the broads, why wouldn't you pretend to be like the people that they say get all the broads? Like, I'm not excusing it, but I'm just saying, I feel like...
Is it NASCAR white?
Well, yes.
That's why. You ain't Robin Thicke white. No, you NASCAR white. That's right. I said it. You ain't already got the black girlfriend. Sorry, no.
Well, okay, see, you're telling on yourself because even though I got that joke, what you should have said was Jack Harlow because that's the hotness right now in that vein.
I know, I'm dating myself. That's
right. You're dating yourself, but that's fine. I love that joke because I love me some Robin Thicke. he has a new, did you know he had a new hit that came out? He dropped a new video the same day as Leave the Door Open and didn't nobody notice his video. And it's a good song. I ended up sending it to my sisters.
That's some bad timing.
And they loved it, but didn't nobody notice his video.
That door stayed open. Oh, yeah. People weren't trying to hear nothing else. They left it open. Hey, damn. Don't shut that door, honey.
The song is good. The video is actually good too. But
I love the one he got in trouble for too. You know, that was the shit.
Didn't nobody notice that video because Bruno and Anderson just took all the air out the room, just snatched it, just.
Locked up the Grammys like, yeah, this is our show. Time for our number yet? Y'all finished yet? Time for us to do it.
Anyway.
Y'all leave the door open for us. We're here. That's what they should have said. Someone's left the door up for us.
Anyway, so if I'm hearing you correctly, if you're macaroni and cheese out of the box white, you cannot be in that lane that we're talking about, right? You can't be in that Robin Thicke for the older set, Jack Harlow
for the younger set.
Younger set lane. And Chet Hanks does not qualify. Is that what I'm hearing?
For nothing.
So who's a... Chet Hanks is who we're talking about in this moment, of course. But just the normal guy on the street, you know, who listens to rap and let's say a young person, let's say somebody, an under 30, who doesn't know better. Does it surprise you that they would try to take on the swag of the people that they are being told again and again, get all the broads, get all the pussy, get all the babes and whatnot?
No, but I mean, you gotta realize who you are.
Yeah.
I mean.
I agree.
Some white guys can do that. Macklemore, you know. There's some guys that just blend in. They're hip. They're cool. You know, they can wear the colors.
That is true.
White as fuck. Macklemore's white as fuck. He's pale.
Right.
But, you know, oh my God. And he's so fucking funny. But,
though, I mean, I love me some Macklemore, but there are a lot of people who.
Oh, I know who, yes, they bag on him for appropriating and whatnot.
Yeah. But I don't, you know what? They can say whatever they want. I love me some Macklemore. But yeah, yes.
I think he's funny as shit. I don't think he tries to take credit for something that he gives props quite a bit for his influences. But anyway, yeah.
And then I also wonder if you can't do that if you're not offering anything.
There's that too.
I mean, the reason we're saying Jack Harlow and Macklemore is they rap, and rap is something invented by Black people, but they do it well. And they're offering, like, I'm offering this. I'm offering you that I'm a rapper, you know, and I know that's what Black people do, but I got the swag to do it. I don't know. Maybe white NBA stars, since NBA is dominated by Black people, maybe they could, but I don't know if he can just sit up there and be an actor and offer that. Like, what's he offering to show us that he has the swag to pull that off? Like, I don't know that he...
Who's an actor?
Chet.
What's he acting? He's an actor? Yeah. He's been in shit? What? I thought he was just Tom Hanks' son. What's he been in?
No, he's an actor.
What's he fucking done?
They just mentioned his show in the...
What the fuck?
He's a TV actor. He's not a
sad ass fucking soap opera. What's he in?
No, Your Honor.
He's in that?
I don't even know what it is, but yes.
It's that show my mom loves about the black judge, the woman judge.
Oh my, your mom loves that show. He's in the show my mom
loves. She always thinks, she likes to think she's down, you know. Yeah. Anyway.
Yeah, maybe he's the judge's love interest. Who knows?
My mom's, you should give my mom a Chet's email.
Like I have it. But anyway, yes, he's an actor. So what I'm saying is he's not really offering anything. To show us that, to show the public that he has the swag to say the things he said.
Right, it's that he has no, yeah. He has no definable skills.
If he could sing like Robin Thicke, if he could rap like Jack Harlow, if he could play basketball, if he could, I don't know what else. I don't know what else. But if he was a porn star that always had black women co-stars, I guess, I don't know. I don't know if that would count, but something. He would have to, he's not offering anything.
I think those stars pretty much go all over the place.
Oh, I didn't even know. I don't know about porn, but. Yeah, so he just put that out there. It's White Boy Summer. Babe, it's your summer. Oh, so wait a minute. So he said, I'm not talking about NASCAR Trump white boys. I'm talking about.
I gotta be diligent with that tanning lotion to get my whiteness down, man. After this, I swear, he's fucking making it hard to be white people these days. I swear. But
is he embarrassing you, babe?
Man, it's hot.
And the thing is, if we did that Dave Chappelle skit, wouldn't nobody want, you couldn't like trade him for anybody because nobody would want him.
Person who took him, we have to get two or three picks as a liability.
Yeah, for real.
This guy, like,
maybe you could
Chet.
Give
even his name, fucking Chet.
Maybe you could give Jack Harlow to the black delegation only if they also took Chet Hanks.
They'd say, oh, that even that's not worth it.
Just so you could offload him.
No, we get Jack and Robin. Get them both. Get them both. Blurred lines. We're going to blur them. That's right.
If we had to take Chet Hanks, we deserve.
That's right.
Jack and Robin. Just to bookend the generations.
That's right. To shore our fucking support up against this fool.
Oh my God, that's funny.
Chet, motherfucker.
No, you know what? I tell you what. If the whites would take Tiger Woods.
Better hope his ex ain't on that team. He's like, come on over, Tiger. This 9-iron's got your name on it. Still got your name on it. Written in your blood right there. There it is.
Ooh-wee.
Yes, sir. That's where I tattooed your chin right here, honey.
Stop.
Tigers roll down that window. Honey, what are you? Oh.
No, she smashed through it.
Fucking what? It's funny if he's rolling down the window like, honey, what? What the? What?
That whole thing, like, why didn't he have two phones? Like, if anybody, he had multiple side women. Why didn't
he
have
two? The phones was not the problem. He would have been found out anyway. He didn't know who or what he was fucking with. I mean, that woman, he was fucking on a woman who was going to fucking put him in the hospital. You don't fuck around a woman like that.
He misjudged. You're right.
Like most cheating men, he misjudged.
That's true. That broad was no punk. That's true. Mm-mm. He thought she was just going to be a blonde little stay-at-home mom.
I ain't heard that kind of come up into in a long time.
Not in a minute. That is true.
She fucking beat his ass in the driveway, made him all run into shit. I can knock his shit unconscious.
But right, that's not funny.
Right in a tree.
I can't laugh. Domestic violence is not funny even when a cute little white girl is doing it to a man who had multiple side bitches. It's still not funny.
I disagree. That was funny shit.
No, it's wrong. Stop. You're setting it out.
I watch that on YouTube every night.
Stop.
Every night.
No, she should have.
I'd wait for that part at the end where, where he hits the horn and he just goes into the tree. Bam. That's where I wet my pants. That's a kill.
No, it's wrong. She should have gone to jail. I said she should have gone to jail.
Oh, hell no.
But just for like maybe a week.
Never. She ever. No.
Because that's it. Listen. We can't say
not
women.
A goddamn thing should happen to women like that, because that's been the wrong message.
We can't say we want men and women to have equality. And then when the wife beats the man's ass, everybody says, ah, ha, ha.
Because that's equality. That's why we're laughing. Because it's been fucking since time immemorial, the guy's been cupping the broad. That's why. And in public. So that's why it's so goddamn funny.
It's not funny.
It's fucking hilarious. I mean,
it's not. That's not the kind of laughter my that sends you to hilarious. Hell.
Watch it every night and still pee my pants. Oh, my God. The moment where he... and then you hear this... fails the golf club. Just throws that thing at the car down there at the end of it. And don't come back. Whack. Then you hear her little heels. Right back up the driveway. Oh my God.
No, it's not funny, honey. It's not funny. Whew. But I just, ooh.
I just wish I could have seen it. Wish I could have filmed that shit. Oh my God.
Oh, wow. Yeah, she, whew. And it wasn't funny when Left Eye burned. Now, okay, I'll tell you what.
If I could come back and be maybe as a celebrity reporter to get film footage of that incident.
I believe she should have gone to jail. Again, only for a week.
All they should have done was just check to see if she'd been drinking.
When Left Eye told her man, you hit me again, I'm going to burn your motherfucking house down. And then he hit her again. And she burnt his house down. And he was smart enough to pay for her lawyer to defend her from his insurance company.
He didn't want to get burned down again. That's right.
Because she
don't
did.
Make me want to burn you down again, motherfucker, because I'll do it.
She did tell him, if you hit me again, I will burn your motherfucking house down with you in it. And he hit her again.
I told him, if I go to jail, I'm going to burn your ass down. So that's why he said, okay. I got
she
your back,
had, babe. She had to back. Show that she was not putting up with being beat. So that in that case, I'm like, okay, that shit is funny. But
Tiger said, wife said, I ain't giving you a second chance. He said, fuck that. You don't need no second chance. You knew you weren't supposed to do this, motherfucker. Plus, this ain't the first time you done it. You've been fucking running around right and left, goddammit. So yeah, that was
who he had to.
That was justified.
And he lied to her face.
That's what I mean. He just was doing it with impunity. One phone, fucking all around. Oh, that bitch ain't gonna do shit. She ain't gonna find out. What? Probably on the phone with those bitches right there in the driveway when she fucking wailed in on him. That's why she caught up with him. She stopped in the driveway because he was fucking with his phone on one of the bitches.
No, she stopped. No, it started in the house. He actually got in the car to get away from her. Before, because he didn't want an incident, and then she chased him.
Motherfucker, where are you going? You see me running his heels before? You know I'll catch you.
And the babies were in the house. Then that part. And he was like, the kids don't need to see this. And he was like, I'm just going to leave. And then she,
any guy would say that regardless. Don't act like he was trying to be good with the kids. May have been right, but that's not the point. That's not why he was leaving, I guarantee you. It was not for the kid's sake. He was getting the fuck out of there because he didn't want to fucking get that nine iron wrapped around his neck, which he got anyway.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
And fucked up his car.
Yes, he did. And got the world in on his business because, I mean, the sports
writers might have grew up ever since.
Fucked
him. He's been right since. Now he ain't never going to be right.
Yeah, but this has nothing to do, this latest thing has nothing to do with his.
No, I know, but I'm just saying physically, he ain't never going to be right.
Anyway, yeah, if the white delegation would take Tiger Woods, then maybe Chet.
Big ask.
Well, Chet Hanks, come on now. I think that's more than fair.
Maybe and Wayne Brady, too.
What'd you say?
Maybe Wayne Brady, too.
Oh, yes. No, no, come on. You know what?
Actually, Wayne's not that bad. He's pretty
No, fair. And you know, Wayne gets... Remember that time that I defended Wayne by saying everybody was being so unfair to him because he's Canadian and you set me straight? All that time, I had been thinking that Wayne acted the way he did because he was from Canada. And I was like, why is everybody making fun of him? They know he's Canadian. Leave him alone. And he is not Canadian at all.
Oh, I thought he was too.
No, you're the one that corrected me.
Did I? Where did I say he was from?
I don't remember, but he's not Canadian.
I thought he was.
Uh-uh. Nope.
You wouldn't know it.
That's why I thought everyone was being mean.
I don't know where the fuck the U.S. is from. He being from Canada. Jesus.
I was like, how are you going to ask him to act like an African-American when he's not an African-American? Mm-hmm. But he is, actually. Mm-hmm. But you know what? There's a diaspora, so he can behave however he wants. And as far as after I'm Wayne Brady, bitch, nobody says. Oh, I know.
That was so fucking gold. How should, yeah.
Gold, just that's pure gold.
That's why I said he was all right.
Just pure gold. That totally, was just.
Probably redeemed himself with that.
If Dave Chappelle never did any other skit but that one, he would still be gold.
Wayne Brady got a choker, bitch?
Run, bitch, run!
Oh!
Run for your life!
I'm Wayne Brady, bitch! That's so funny.
It was.
He needed that.
Do you really think Chet Hanks is pathological?
I do.
But you don't know. I mean,
I know.
No, like pathological how? Like, what do you mean?
Like, he's not right. I mean, like he there's social cues he doesn't get. He's unable to get. That's what I mean by pathological. That's pathological just means it's ingrained in you, right? I mean, there's people often think that that's synonymous with being like a psycho killer, but it means a lot of things. People are pathological liars, or pathological this, or pathological that. But he's a pathological, he's just not hip socially.
You know who, what? It would crack me.
His high school years must have been painful.
I don't see how. He's Tom Hanks' son.
Because he's got no clue how to act socially. That's why.
Or at least not on social media. Who knows how he acts in private?
He's no judge of his own thing. You know what I mean? I mean, even if you weren't getting social cues, I'd know not to put that shit out there.
Yeah, for real. Right? For real. Yeah.
After I got the memes, I might like maybe reevaluate. Like, oh, fuck. You know, but no, this guy proceeds on. Let me make clear rather than abandoning completely white boy summer, he says, let me make clear what I mean about white boy summer. No, wrong direction, my friend.
What kind of reaction was he looking for?
Oh, God. And I just feel his fucking parents cringing. Jesus.
Could you just see
both Tom of Hanks? Them are so effing hip, you know what I mean? They're just totally got their fingers on the zeitgeist, the both of them. They're a power couple. They just always right where they need to be, doing what needs to be done. I mean, they were right in, even in the middle of the fucking COVID epidemic. There they were, the first people getting affected, telling everybody, wear your mask, shut down, you know? I mean, they're just... And here their son is just an utter and complete embarrassment. Anyway.
And for what? Like, he's Tom Hanks' son. He could pretty much talk about anything.
It's for fucking attention. You know why? People are vapid in our society. You know, they just...
You know, people who choose to become professional actors have to have a certain amount of attention seeking.
This guy's not a professional actor.
Honey, he's on a real show.
He's gone into acting because his dad did it, but he's not a professional actor.
Babe, if you make your money acting, you are a professional actor.
I don't know how. Okay, he's not a very good professional
actor. Oh, that, hey, I won't debate again, that. I have never seen the
professionality.
Show.
Professional in the sense he gets paid for it, but not professional in the sense that he's a professional.
I didn't say he was a thespian. I said he was.
I'm not even saying, yeah, he's not even professional.
he makes his living acting.
Only that in the strictest sense.
Honey, you haven't even seen him on the show. You didn't even know.
Can we
he
just
might
say
be good.
Paid actor instead of professional? Is that all right? We just say paid actor. He's a paid actor. That's how he makes his living. But can we just leave out the word professional? Just pains me. It just, no, it just won't work.
You didn't even know he was on the show. So how do you know he's bad?
Because I know his face probably doesn't change a bit from what I just saw in that video.
You know what? What's the name of the show, Your Honor? Let's watch a clip. Let me find a clip. I'm just curious now.
You really have to? It's going to put you in your place. So you'll know what I'm talking about.
Okay. So let's just find a clip.
You're going to say, oh, he is pathological. How did you know?
That's what I'm going to say, babe.
No, you don't.
So give me a good fucking deal, because this is just the start.
Get all into it, babe. Last role he'll ever have.
You thought that was bad?
It was all right for what it was.
You expected to be utter and complete crap, and he wasn't.
Meh. It's hard to tell.
So if he can really act, I don't know why he comes out here with this nonsense.
I don't know if, again, I don't know if he can really act. And, you know, as crazy as it is, some actors don't have any social fucking clue.
Oh, that is, which is kind of strange because they're actors.
That's what I said. It's crazy as sound because you've got to be really in touch with your own feelings and how other people react and feel to be a good actor, because you've got to be believable in your portrayals. And so usually actors are very sensitive and hip. But, you know, every once in a while you get those total right-wing nutters who are in acting, and it's just, because politics does make a big deal. It's what you're tolerant of. It's what you want to, artists experiment, and they, you know, it's just a whole different mindset.
Of course, if you don't like yourself, then one way to get into acting is because you enjoy portraying other people. And if you don't like yourself, that would be a reason to put on a persona that's really, you know, not authentic and doesn't even come off as authentic. And you know what? I think that's what it is that makes it so bad. His whole trying to have swag is he's not authentic. It looks like a put on. If he would commit.
At the very least.
You know, I'm sure there's other white guys out there who are perceived to have swag and they're not, it's not authentic for them either. They just commit and make it look like it's authentic.
Well, the other thing is, class does matter, and you can't dumb yourself down to being one of the white boys. You're Tom Hanks' fucking son. I'm sorry. you're not one of the white boys. You know, you're not. At least you shouldn't be. I mean, yeah, that's what I.
So he's slumming on top of everything else.
Yes, that's what he's doing. Exactly. So, yeah, because he's just inauthentic and all, just all rap.
So he mentioned what type of white boy summer it was going to be. Him, John B., and Jack Harlow. Well, I had never, before 2 weeks ago when Jack Harlow had his Tiny Desk concert, I had never heard of him.
Yeah, me either.
And that Tiny Desk concert, I blew me away. It was so good. But whew, that album. That band that he had on Tiny Desk was so tight, so tight. And no wonder I learned that two of the musicians in that band
were from. He was no Robin Thicke, was he?
Well, he raps, so it's not about this. I mean, Robin Thicke can sing. But anyway, that band was so tight. It ended up two of the members are from Kendrick Lamar, so it's no wonder. And then you go to the album, and there's no musicianship on it. It's just...
I wonder when rap is going to die. That's what I wonder.
It's not. You know what somebody said in the comments on Jack Harlow?
I don't know that.
No, listen. It's what someone said in the comments was, this is where rap's going, where you use live musicians and actual good music, and you put the rap to that. You
still do your shit rap over the top of it.
But my God, when you have those good ass musicians, it makes the rap sound so good. I mean, that was a good ass Tiny Desk concert.
Well, I'm sure it does, but it's still just still rap.
And actually, he had something to say. I mean,
we'll sing it then.
Well, but see, not everybody can sing. Yeah, that don't ask people to do that.
Then you should be playing an instrument. Damn it. Get out of music then.
I mean, rap is nothing but poetry, and they had beat poets that did their poetry over music.
I wish they'd go back to it.
In any case.
Go to the slam. Get out of music.
I would not buy his album, but I would listen to that Tiny Desk concert again. And if he ever does like a B-sides album where it's those live musicians, he has my money. Oh, that band was so tight. That was a good... Anyway, I had never heard of John B. And so when he put John B.'s name next to Jack Harlow...
I didn't know until you read it.
I was like, oh, well, let me check out John B. Maybe he has a Tiny Desk concert. I just didn't know. Babe, when I show you who John B. is, you are going to pee your pants laughing. I was like, you have got to be kidding me. Hold on. Let me get this. Heard about past things that you said. I know. Can you? If I didn't know this was him, I would think this was a Saturday Night Live skit. Think I'm
doing wrong. Oh, seriously, huh? Oh, my God.
Yeah, I've heard enough. But he had multiple hits. That song is from 11 years ago.
No excuse.
He was on the Soul Train Music Awards 2 years ago because people loved him. I was like, I've never heard it. Yeah. So anyway, that's the kind of hot boy summer it's gonna white boy summer it's white gonna be. Boy. So babe, this is your moment.
Stop it. Stop it right now. Get my Bieber Forever t-shirt.
His, you know what?
My Bieber fever t-shirt.
His Tiny Desk concert wasn't bad.
I don't even hear that anymore.
It wasn't bad. I can't.
I don't care. I don't care how fucking great it was. He's still just a Bieber. Just to try to figure out why his name went in there. Fucking fell out. Now I know what dude's talking about after those other names in there. Shit. Jesus. Bieber does belong in. That is the kind of white boy he's talking about. Bieber.
Don't talk bad about Jack Harlow like that. You don't know. He's good, actually. Oh, just not that album, but oof.
All right. Well, I know John B's in there. And
yeah, I know. I mean, you and I are not feeling John B at all, and I knew you wouldn't, but apparently he was the shit back.
We got Chet, old Chet fucking Hanks here. White boy summer. Wow. Oh.
I am.
Where do you go with that?
I'm not really sure. Well, you tell people what shoes and t-shirts they can and can't wear. And
I tell you where you go with it. You make a manifesto for what white boy summer is all about.
Yeah.
Do's and don'ts.
Yeah.
This is our white boy summer credo.
Isn't that you doing white boy summer in the background? On the door.
Oh, wow. So fucking funny. So fucking funny.
You started the trend, babe, back in the day.
I don't know what you're talking about.